Hello po sa lahat. Throughout the next sign and symptoms overview. The throat and the front of the neck form an area in which practically all channels converge, with a single exception of the bladder channel. 11 of the 12 channels course through either the front or the side of the throat. Of the 8 extraordinary vessels, 6 go through the center or the side of the throat. The exception are the governing vessel and the girdle vessel, thus being influenced by so many channels and therefore internal organs. The throat reflects clearly condition of yin yang. Heat, cold, and deficiency exists and is an important diagnostic area. The throat is influenced particularly by the lungs, stomach, large intestine, liver, kidneys, and the erecting vessels channels. Chinese medicine talks about throat in general without distinguishing pharynx related to both respiratory and digestive system. From the larynx pertaining to the respiratory system, there are, however, signs that the ancient Chinese doctors were aware of such differentiation. For example, even as early as 100 BC, the spiritual access said in chapter 69, the throat is the passage for food and drinks. The throat is also where qi goes up and down. It is interesting that the Chinese text uses two different terms in this sentence, yan hu for passage of food and ho long for passage of qi. Both are translated as throat in modern texts, bearing in mind the dual function of the throat in the respect of respiratory and the digestive system. One can generally differentiate two broad types of throat problems, one related to the respiratory system and in Chinese medicine to the lungs and kidney channels, and the other related to the digestive system and in Chinese medicine to the stomach and large intestine channels. In adults, chronic sore throats are more commonly related to the lungs and kidney channels, and in children, more commonly to the stomach and large intestine channels. With regard to heat and cold, the throat is prone only to heat, whether full or empty, and does not have any cold patterns. Why, we ask? As about throat symptoms, to confirm either a pattern of heat, because the throat is an area of concentration of heat, or a pattern of qi stagnation. As about neck symptoms, to confirm the presence of liver pattern such as liver qi stagnation or liver yang rising, which varying invasion of external cold are the most common causes of chronic neck ache. When we ask, so it is useful to ask about the throat symptoms when there is heat, full or empty, or qi stagnation, if no earlier mention of throat symptoms has been made, ask about them towards the end of the consultation. Always ask about the throat when suspect a pattern of rebellious qi of the penetrating vessel. Ask patient whether they experience a feeling of tightness in the throat or a sensation of heaving lumps in the throat. If the patient speak of discomfort in the neck, it is important to ask him or her to point clearly to the area involved. The side of the neck are influenced by the gallbladder channel and often liver patterns, while the back of the neck is influenced by the bladder channel. Thank you for your attention.